Hello, this is Boris, and today we build budget PC. Instead of thermal paste, we use mayonnaise. Let's see what happened. Let's begin.
Yes, Boris!
Imagine this, you go to store, buy all the PC parts you need. CPU, yes, color, yes, memory, of course, graphics card, oh, the best part. It need to run no less than Metro Exodus, billion. So you run home, start assembling, motherboard, memory, SSD, power supply, CPU, fan, oh wait, there is some hole, oh no, I forgot the thermal paste again. And instead of running back to store, which is already closed, and all your friends are already online waiting for you to jump into game, you think, what if I not use thermal? Okay, that's a bad idea. Running a CPU without thermal paste at all is like frying egg on a pan without any oil. Technically it works, but you will burn it up faster. Then you can see oil mama called fat by Andy Hassan fan. Okay. At least it's warm. And that is why we need thermal paste. But I'll see you not have the overpriced brand one. But you do have some mayonnaise. Or at least you should have. Bill, how you survive without it? If it's good for you, it must be good for PC. And since we're not rich people here, I did set some rules for this build. Number one, every component has to be new from the shop. Nothing refurbished or reused. Number two, everything has to be the cheapest possible option. And number three, it has to be all components ready in the store. No ordering, no waiting for some discount. And of course, no scavenging bad from all PCs. Should be fine. And just like that, we should have the perfect head of my PC. And just like PC, table's budget as well. Where from Kazin Atoli since he's stuck in army anyway. And yes, since many of you have been asking in community posts how it sounds so good all the time, I am wearing a very high quality microphone in front of my face, and this way I'm not sure my head almost not at all. Because it just look ridiculous. Unlike his case, being it looking good. It also comes with thumb screws that you saw, because we're not savages here. Whoa, for kids costing 1800 rubles. It comes surprisingly well equipped, look at that. The brand is deep cold, poor man's fractal design. For motherboard, I went with a 520mh by Gigabyte. It also has M.2 slot. From the box you might have already guessed, yes, we're going with AMD CPU this time. Because AMD CPUs at this price point are way more powerful. Beautiful. It also does support dual channel DDR4. Price point about 5200 ruble, I think. About $70. One AMD Ryzen 5 1600. Small editorial note here. The CPU is not actually supported by this motherboard. I did realize a bit too late, but we do fix this later in the video. Keep watching. 6 cores, 12 threads, not bad. Now this PC is about 4 years old at this point, but if it was not, it would not be cheapest one available. But we'll do just fine for this build. And not to the obvious bottleneck of this whole device, it is the cheapest graphics card you can buy over the counter as we speak. 1050 Ti from Gigabyte, but should be good enough to run Metro Exodus on at least minimum settings. But most important, this PC is built for mayonnaise cooling, and also be a nice test rig for any future cheek-breaky we have planned. Not bad. I might actually put water cooling in this machine at some point. The cheapest memory available, G-Skill Edges DDR4. Unfortunately, it is not possible to buy 4GB sticks, so maybe we can just buy another 8GB stick for future dual channel speed. One power supply, enough to feed the hungry 1050 Ti, and the processor as well with no problem. It also has 80 plus bronze, which is pretty much standard at this point. Now since this is the cheapest one, it is not modular at all, but we fix this with some Slavic handicraft. I was wondering if these power supplies come with this cable. Now we know. The cheapest SSD you can buy, by the way, is M.2 Western Digital Green 240GB. I have a feeling there should be cheaper options than this, but in store, this was cheapest. At 2200 rubles, it was like $30? But it will make this machine fly! Now, I must admit this was a bit of a stupid buy, since the CPU already comes with basic cooler, but I have had some bad experiences with inbox coolers before, so this is just for my peace of mind. One very cheap extra case fan, in case things run very hot. Now this is completely for comfort, but I could not resist at this price, come on! Also very useful if I take this PC to friend's house, and he not have cable connection. And for some beautiful cable management, some black zip ties. And for accurate testing, some RTK MX4 thermal compound and some basic mayonnaise, use what you have. Oh, it should be fine. So I did some calculation, it should be without the additional CPU cooler or the Wi-Fi card very nicely below $500. So if you want to follow along at home, please go ahead, build yourself a mayonnaise machine as well, but not before you see what actually happens. Let's start the construction. One IO plate, one SATA cable we not need, and one beautiful MATX Gigabyte motherboard with M4 slot. I'm not even sure why I'm opening this cable, because we do not have any SATA drives. Still, nice, thank you, Gigabyte. This will go into the box forever. Haha, now besides dust prevention, I have fleet or IO shield. Actually also helps prevent your PC from getting killed by static electricity, which I actually have, interesting enough, never had problem with, even though for most of my life I've been living in a house made of carpet. Oh, mom, look at that. One M4 socket and brackets for holding down the cooler. One M.2 slot, wireless cable for me, nice. Just two RAM slots, that is just what you get for this money. And one PS2 slot for inserting keyboard from the 80s. Welcome, grandchildren, if you're watching this from the year 2067. People used to have analog inputs for keyboards. It is strange, I know. And you also have about 10 years to live up to the cyberpunk reality. So it is a smart idea to assemble everything outside of the case first, as I also did in my vodka cool PC build, which is still running. So first, let's install the SSD. This M.2 is basically just like putting in some RAM. You slide it into the slot and use the screw if there ever was one. What the f***? Man, I thought I have seen it all. To see 5 cents on every billion motherboards they make, they have replaced the screw with this plastic thing. It does not even come on! Oh, you did it not! Ова! What an unnecessary invention. Come on, Gigabyte, you can do better than this. How am I even supposed to attach to the smaller drives? Do you assume I have many of these plastic nibbles laying around? And done. Next up, 1 6-core 12-thread machine. It will be your task to power this budget build. One default cooler, this will not use, but technically it is good enough if you not have money laying around for the one. Very small heatsink, so not exactly ideal. We install the CPU, lift the handle, align this corner with the yellow CPU corner. Ooh, nice and tight. Put the latch back on and pretty much done. Enough for details. This is the fan we are using, has actual copper inside and thermal paste already. On both sides, attach on the latches. Oba! Tighten it up, nice! And blin, it already looking nice. We can attach the CPU fan power already. What the f***? Come on, how this always happen? Every time we build PC, blin. Attach a CPU fan cable because there is not much management we can do with this one. The motherboard usually says CPU fan, so you're not accidentally sticking wrong hole. Some RAM. Sticker will leave a letter, make sure it aligns correctly with the hole below. And if your motherboard has more than 2 slots for RAM, make sure you install the lost numbers first, like A0 and then B0, because the dual channel actually working. That is pretty much it for the motherboard. We have the CPU cooler, RAM, SSD, cable already attached. Blin, this is the simplest build I've ever done. And for the case, it is always a good idea to get to know the case before you attach anything inside, since most of them do not actually come with user manuals at all. Okay, let's remove the back panel as well for some slight cable management. Good news, as you can see, the motherboard stands or feet are already attached, so you can just throw the board inside. But first install case fan, because later we have much less room to do it. Ah yes, again, deep coil, probably run on 50 decibels on idle. Now in this case we have like 3 positions to put this in, on the front panel, in the back, or in the front. Basically it does not matter all that much. If you have one case fan, you just want to get air flowing inside. But me, I like to put it in the back. Now fans only work in one direction, it is this direction, so you pretty much want to decide if you want the air blowing in or out of the case. For me, I choose to blow the hot air out of the case instead. You can flip this fan around whenever you want. It's not bad. The IO plate, make sure it is the right side up, and that the markings are on the outside, not in. Generally speaking, the audio jack should be at the bottom. Now let's throw this sucker inside. Again, make sure that the ports line up with the plate. And inside we go. Align the ports, good. And I just realized there are some feet missing for the motherboard. Blin, this is what the feet look like. They hold up the motherboard from the case. One's missing right here. Not exactly sure why we do not have this in the case. This is M80X motherboard, blin. And we have a party. Now that all the holes on the motherboard line up, we insert the screws to hold it in place. If you're not completely sure which screws are the correct ones, then they are usually the ones that there is most of in the back. In my case, these are very small, flat screws, and these are the wrong ones. Okay, now we have something. I tell you, deep cool is trying to trick me again. You better watch out, or you get pissed. La 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 la. And another 2 screws right here. By the way, this hoodie that I'm wearing, you cannot actually get this in store just yet. This is one of a kind. But to keep checking back, I'm about to update the store. Okay, board not falling out. Success. Ports are aligned. Good. Which means it is time for the power supply. 450 watts of pure mayonnaise power. Imported, As you can see, nothing module, but it looks good. One horrible amount of cables, but we hide this in the back. And I just realized this blowing in the air from the case and the hot air is coming out, which means we need to flip over the case fan later on, slide this into the case, bring it just small. Those expecting power supplies will be much bigger than that. Look at that, it actually looks like it belongs here. By the way, this is the one good thing about these budget parts. You can almost always be sure to get black components, like this matte black. Screw in the power supply nice and tight. So this is the back of the case where you hide all the cables, usually coming in from here. And okay, that is a lot. Imagine just cut this off. This is where modular power supplies exist, but here twice the price. So not for me. Let's start with a big socket 24-pin connector for the motherboard. Take it through the hole and now the rest. And we take the big socket and stick it down in the next hole. Yes, these holes are not by accident here. They are meant for cable management. Yes, even in this cheap case. Plug in the big socket right next to CPU, right next to the RAM. Tighten up the cable from behind so that when your comrades come to visit you and admire your handicraft, they will surely say, "Bling." You have way too much time on your hands. But trust me, you will be having the last laugh because your PC will still be running while gears have burned on 5-6 times already. So you see, cable management. Smart. Next up, let's put in the CPU power. This is a 8-pin connector and the plug is very close above the CPU right... here. Push the access cable back. Not bad. Let's just leave the PC Express power cable right here for powering the graphics card. And the rest pretty much useless for me. You can try hide this behind, but in case of this case, it does not fit. For exactly this, there is this area on the back cover. It's for cable management, not making your PC look faster. And one more small thing, the case fan actually connects right to the motherboard, and the socket is right next to CPU. And the name says System Fan. And I still forgot to flip it around, shit. Now we come to the biggest headache and the ultimate challenge of any build. Connecting the case cables. Why have not this been unified into one port? Still have no idea. There is the HD audio pass-through for the front panel, USB port, power LEDs and so on. But connecting all these small cables is still something they do not teach you in school. You just need to read the diagram on the board and read the labels and hope you get everything correct. You did put something disappointing in the manual, they do not. Wish me luck. And we are back. Do not mind the mess, the graphics card will cover that up nice. And before we do any more cable management, let's install the cards. Now, even though this is a very cheap and ridiculously underpowered card in 2021, it will still be far more than enough to run Stalker, to run Metro 1 or 2, and basically hopefully not completely burn down when we run Metro Exodus on this device. And most importantly, test the mayonnaise cooling. Let's install. Remove this cover we not need, and we need to remove some of these back covers. Since this is a very cheap case, you just basically have to break this off. On more expensive cases, you can save this for later and reattach with screws, but this is just trash. And because this is not a low profile GPU, we need to remove one more cover. Oh, that's what I like to hear. Put in the short screws with the wide head, usually that's how it is. In case your case manufacturer has not included a manual, let's plug in the GPU power straight into the card. And the GPU does not need any extra power, what a nice day. I guess we just set this cable back. The whole system probably just runs on 200 watts alone. I mean, I do not mind, this was still the cheapest power supply available. And it will draw only the power that you need, so... A very nice end of the month budget machine. You could probably run this off a bicycle. Okay, let's put all the black in the front and try to hide. Because clearly this case was not meant for a lot of cable management. Some bigger cases actually come with a very big compartment in this place. You can hide your cables without anybody noticing. But in this case, technically we could just wrap this all up and hide where the drives usually go, since we actually have none. Why? What is your other question? I cannot wait to start this up. That is one clean build. Dust will just walk right on when you see this case. Let's check, of course, we not forget the Wi-Fi card. Another thing I assume it will be in every motherboard at this point. But then again, it just costs $10. And what the blin else you're going to use this PCIe slot for? And one, and two. We are ready. And remove the plugs, of course, from the ports. And I think we have created something. Forgot the fan! Yeah! So when you're building a machine with more than one case fan, it is smart to have them all blowing separate directions and not all blowing in or out. You should just one or two in from the front and one out from the back. Or just one in from the side panel, one out from the back is fine. But we do not use the side panel fan, not just because we didn't actually buy one. But you also need to disconnect and connect again every time you open the case. Not exactly fun. And flip it around.
Nice. Is somebody home? This cannot be good. I bet Vadim finally drilled the hole through the wall and straight into PC when I was not I bought the wrong motherboard in that. AMD not support old series and Samsung and Boris. Come on, this is basic knowledge. And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, gobniks and PC enthusiasts. As you can probably not see, I have swapped out the motherboard and reinserted everything and applied, of course, the thermal paste already because I had to remove and reinstall the heatsink and CPU, so the factory stuff that was on the heatsink is now gone. This is running ATIC MX4. And as it turns out, the cheapest motherboard at the time was the 520 chipset, but what I needed was the 320 chipset to support a 1 series Ryzen CPU. And here we go again, attempt number 1.5. Mayonnaise machine, revision 1.1. Oba! Oba! It lives! You beautiful bastard! Ah, блин. Ну, let's just use some windows for testing purposes. Блин, I do have good feeling about this build. Well, there is nothing else to do but pour yourself a tall glass of vodka. And hoping number done. And what we see, 44 degrees flat, the decision numbers. But by the way, let's get some benchmarks going. Metro, Stalker, Doom, maybe Cyberpunk, if we're lucky. Well, I do have some good news and some even better news. On Full HD, at least on high quality, it still push at 40 plus FPS. Let's see what happens if we put too low. Oh, change these numbers. 60 FPS Metro Exodus. She's a $500 machine. Yes, I know it is low setting, but this is how it is supposed to be played. Small dip here. It's just probably loading rest of level. This GPU is just waiting for payday here. Okay, 80, 70, 60. Still not a problem. Okay, and a bit of running outside. Let's get the PC nice and hot. And after about 10-15 minutes of Metro Exodus, on low settings, but still, it makes that at 50 degrees. And waiting for idle, drop back to 40. Very nice.
Morning, Night City!
Yes, thank you, Microsoft. Okay, this might be a bit too ambitious, but still, who's going to stop me? Oh, mama sent backup. It actually ran. What the? Oh, Infinity is nice. 80 FPS 9. The question is how it is still running. What kind of miracle is this? Okay, I've bumped everything down to the lowest possible setting. And 22 FPS. This is not bad. It's a very respectable result for end-of-month budget PC. And temperature stay at 50. Okay, just going between 50 and 49. But then again, CPU utilization is like at best 50%. And let it cool down to island, we see again 40. Very nice. I would say just complete. Let's shut down. Open up. So this was air-powered ATIC MX4, running on 50, idling at 40. Let's clean up the heatsink, do some detailing on these ridges so it not ruin the mayonnaise experience. Clean up the CPU as well. And back in the hole it goes. Nice and clean. It is ready to become a very high-tech booty abroad. And this is actual mayonnaise. And that's a magical thermal compound. Let's take a nice small bit, not using more than we need. Come on, come on. Ah, perfection. Reapply the clean heatsink. Reattach the cable so we're not burning house down. I think we're ready. Mayonnaise machine, revision 1.2. First time ever, replacing thermal paste with mayonnaise. Давай, let's make some history. After putting out this temperature stated to nice and cold 36, Stalker played at a very stable 44 degrees. After dropping to idle and waiting to cool down, instead of 40 degrees with thermal paste, the CPU dropped down to 37. I swear you cannot make this shit up. So of course they ran Cyber 77. The CPU, yes, peaks at 50 once again. The GPU for whatever reason stays a bit cooler than before. I ran Metro and again similar results. Peak at 50. And after 15-20 minutes of gaming and dropping to idle and waiting to cool, the CPU dropped back to 37. So of course I needed to go back and double check. I ran Stalker again. This time it ran on 46 degrees. But at this point it could have already been that the ambient temperature of the room has risen so much. But after seeing once again CPU dropping to idle of 37, I was convinced and the test was complete. Yes, not only you can use mayonnaise as thermal paste, but it is even more efficient and will run cooler than thermal paste. For next PC, we build vodka cooled and mayonnaise thermal paste ultimate Slavic gaming machine. Just think of the thermal performance we can achieve. Delicious. And yes, you are definitely wondering what does mayonnaise look after it has been run as a thermal paste for roughly 2 hours of gaming. It looks like this. It has not evaporated, it has not boiled away. Instead, it has secured its position. And guess what? It's still just good. And thank you for watching, everybody. This concludes the test. It is a complete success. PC not just ran on mayonnaise. It ran better on mayonnaise. Actually, it goes with everything. Forget this overpriced cream. Go for Slavic mayonnaise. Also, if you have not already, click that join button. Join the channel subscription. Get a nice loyalty badge. Next to your name in the comments. And for me, you are Chicky Bricky. Давай, I will see you next time, my friends. Boris out.